I think I'll start off by acknowledging the community itself, because later on when we are reflecting on this process, there was this expression that one of the biggest achievements in Huruma was to build a community that can then build houses. So in my view, the community has been built. The task of building houses is a long-term one, and that can go on for many days. So the crucial thing that, in my view, was achieved is that building of the community. So at least we've got a community that can then carry on with the agenda that was raised at that point. But of course, beyond that, the fact that we went on the ground and put out a number of houses, prototypes, that the community can then duplicate, in my view, that's an achievement. And the fact that these houses can be duplicated, not just in Kambi Moto, but in other settlements, that's an achievement, because it means it's a model that has its own life and can move out there and change communities. I'm saying this because I've heard of other communities borrowing from Kambi Moto and using not just the product, but also the process, because the setting out of the process in Huruma is a big achievement. The process itself, of course, the product is good, but we want to say the process of arriving at that house is good. And partly because of entrenching a concept or a model for participation in urban slum upgrading. Because initially we didn't have any model for participation. So this model for participation that was perfected in Kambi Moto and in the entire Huruma is good. The other achievement was to bring down the top to the grassroots. In my view, Kambi Moto has achieved in that, in the sense that if you go to the urban authorities and mention Kambi Moto, the urban authorities recognize Kambi Moto as a legitimate settlement, one way or the other. And this bringing out is not just, you know, symbolic. It's also practical. I mean, these people in administration in the urban authorities have been to Kambi Moto practically, and they've gone in and seen how the place has changed. So in my understanding, the top has come down. I would also say the bottom has gone up. Because today, if you talk to the community in Kambi Moto, they feel empowered. In fact, like, I wouldn't be surprised, some of them will be vying for big offices with time because of that empowerment. And if you go down to a settlement in Mahera, I think now they've got a ward, a representative for the ward, who is a resident of Mahera. And it's purely because of this empowerment. And the empowerment didn't focus on housing alone. I may be just discussing housing, but in my view, it was empowerment both socially, economically, and politically. So that really achieved a lot. But of course, most of the time we celebrate the houses because they are the easily identifiable products of this process. But I believe that the process has achieved a lot.